Hey friends, Microsoft Copilot for Azure is an AI companion that simplifies how you use Azure. Now in Azure Cosmos DB, you can turn your data questions into Azure Cosmos DB NoSQL queries using the Azure Cosmos DB Data Explorer. James Codella is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with James Codella, who's going to teach me all about Microsoft Copilot for Azure within the context of Azure Cosmos DB. How are you, sir?
Good, Scott. Really happy to be here with you. How are you doing?
I am very well. Let's have some fun, because I always learn something when I hang out with the Cosmos team, and then I end up hitting stop as soon as we're done with the show, and then I implement it on one of my sites. So I want to know what you're going to give me, and then I'm going to go and exploit it.
Yeah, absolutely. So you're going to have a lot of fun playing with this. So we've heard from a lot of customers around their experience in writing Cosmos DB NoSQL queries. And as you're familiar, there's a lot of nuances to our NoSQL syntax. It's extremely powerful, extremely flexible, but sometimes writing really complex queries can be a little bit cumbersome, especially if you're relatively new to the Cosmos DB ecosystem. So we've developed Microsoft Copilot for Azure in Cosmos DB. So it allows you to take your natural language questions about your data and use Copilot to turn those into the Cosmos DB NoSQL queries. It's a really powerful tool in the Data Explorer in the Azure portal. It's powered by state-of-the-art Azure OpenAI large language models. Your data in Cosmos DB and your usage of Copilot is private, secure, and never used for training any models and never leaves the Microsoft or Azure Cosmos DB infrastructure. And it's developed with Microsoft's responsible AI principles. You know, we spent countless hours and thousands of test cases ensuring that the model is not biased, that it's not producing erroneous results. But, you know, like any large language model application, it's not perfect. So any query that you generate using the Copilot should be validated by an actual human being first, checking it for validity. And again, it's important to note that right now this is in public preview and we're continuing to make updates to it. In fact, I think we just deployed a small update to it earlier today. So we're continuously making improvements on it. But I'd love to dive right into it and show you an example of what it can do.
That's very cool. I'd like to see this.
Yeah. So here we have my Cosmos DB test account. I'm in the Data Explorer. This is the welcome screen that we all know and love for the Data Explorer. And if you have enrolled in the Copilot preview, and I'll get to how you can do that in a minute, but if I've enabled the Copilot preview, I'll see a new card here. I'll see this query faster with Copilot card. And if I click on this, it will take me to a new SQL editor where I can become familiar with Copilot using a sample data set that contains some synthetic data that we created so you can become familiar with Copilot. And I can see that right here. So that's one way to get started with Copilot. The other way is just to dive right in and start creating queries, right? So I'm gonna do that. So I have this sample data set here. I have a movie lens data set. So it's information about some popular movies. It doesn't contain every single movie, but it contains quite a few. So I'm gonna say, let's create a new SQL query. And I can see the query editor that I'm very familiar with, but I see I see something new, right? I see this Copilot interface up top, and it says ask a question in natural language, and we'll generate the query for you. So I'm going to go ahead, and I've listed a couple. You know, I've used this extensively, so I'm going to call up one of the prompts that I've submitted before, which is, you know, show me the first 10 items. So sometimes if you're not sure what's in your data set or you're looking at some data that maybe somebody has shared with you, maybe you're not familiar with the schema, maybe you're not familiar with what's in it. So you might want to take a peek and see what's actually in your database. And so what I've done here is I've clicked the generate query button and then—
Could I ask that you just hit command plus and just give me a little bit more font size there because I want to make sure that I'm picking up all of this. All right. Thank you so much.
Sure. So after clicking the generate Copilot button, after clicking the generate query button, I see Copilot has generated a few things for me in the data editor. First, I can see at the bottom, here's the query that Copilot believes corresponds to the prompt that I gave it. Then I can see a natural language explanation of the query, which is easy to understand. And then I can see the prompt that I entered for reference. and then I can execute it just like any Cosmos DB query, and I can see the results down below in the results pane. So I can see like there's a James Bond movie, there's a bunch of different movies here, cool. So it shows me the first top documents in my database, right? That's pretty easy task. So we can do something a little bit harder and put Copilot to the test. So I'm going to ask it, what movies have James Bond in the overview that were also shot in France, and only show me the movie name and the year it was produced?
See, that's really interesting one, because how could it know, right? Does it know about that? If production countries is a thing where you know it, it's not going to IMDb, it's not going to the internet. So it has the corpus of information as the corpus in your database, correct?
That's right. Yeah. So in the Copilot backend, securely, Copilot is able to see what a general schema is across documents in your collection. And so from that, it's able to infer from the language that I enter in as a prompt what correlates to the properties of my documents, right? I didn't name these properties. I didn't name, production countries, right? Or title or things like that. But because the large language model is able to capture some semantic meaning between my prompt and the documents or schema in my collection, it's able to make that inference automatically.
That's so cool. There's so many little things to point out. Like you said, shot in France, right? Like a colloquial way of saying it was produced, it was created, it was filmed in France, and it gleaned production countries must be the thing that it needs for that, and then presumed that France would be the string it would need, and it wrote a pretty darn good query right there that looks on its face like it would work.
Yeah, exactly. And if you're familiar with Cosmos DB, it even used a subquery, which can be a little bit complex to write properly or reference properly. So it did a pretty good job. Now, if I look at the results down here, I can see, and again, because I have my screen zoomed in a little bit, I can see that there's a couple movies here that it gives me. I think it's A License to Kill and Moonraker, with the two James Bond movies shot in France. I'm pretty sure there's a scene in GoldenEye that's from France too, but maybe I just don't have that detail in my database. So we'll let Copilot have a pass on that.
This is a really great example and a really good demo of toil. Like, you just want to do the thing. I know what I want. I just want to do the thing. Yeah. I don't want to have to go and Google with Bing for exists in the subquery Cosmos thing. Now, once you did it, you tickled my neurons and I said, oh, I remember the exists function and why I would need it. I remember that pattern now, but this is a way of removing the not fun part and getting me to the fun part faster.
Exactly. And so right now the Copilot interface, is pretty simple. I can have a prompt here and it will generate a query for me. But for our next release, we are going to have a conversational interface. So if Copilot generates a query and then maybe it's not quite what I'm looking for and I need some sort of modification, rather me going in and editing the query in the query editor, I can actually still use natural language and work with Copilot to create the query that I'm actually looking for. So really powerful stuff that's coming in the pipeline. And I'll show here in this experience. So if I think that the query is actually pretty good, I can go ahead and give a thumbs up and give the additional feedback here. So I can say like, this is very cool. Great job.
Right. And that's totally permissive and goes directly to the Copilot team to go and then look at the query and the prompt and determine that the two worked well.
Exactly. And this is stored securely in Microsoft's infrastructure, so you don't need to worry about your schema or your data being open at all. And again, this is not used for training any AI model and doesn't leave Microsoft. So I can go give a submit here. If I think it could do a better job, I can give a thumbs down. And that pretty much is it for our Copilot experience here. I will mention again that it is a preview feature, and as an Azure preview feature, you have to go and enable it for your subscription. And it's pretty easy to go and do that. Let me just show you a quick example here. In this tab, I have my subscription, my Cosmos DB demos general use subscription. And along here in the left-hand pane, I'll see under settings, there's a preview features tab. And if I click on preview features tab, I'll see all of the preview features that are available to me to apply to multiple different resources in my subscription here. And what I'll want to do is I'll want to scroll down or Control F and find the Microsoft Copilot for Azure in Cosmos DB feature. And I'll want to click on that. We can see some information about what it does and some privacy terms as well. And then I can register my subscription. So every single Azure Cosmos DB NoSQL resource in that subscription will then be able to use Copilot. And I will mention, Copilot is free to use in the Azure portal, and it will remain free.
That's cool. So preview for now, go to preview features. If you scroll up to the very top there, there's a little filter. Now you have every preview feature that's ever existed going back years. Type in Copilot, click, register, you're in. And then, of course, when it goes GA, you'll continue to be in and be able to use that that feature.
Exactly.
Very, very cool. Well, thanks so much for sharing this with me. I'm going to go turn it on right now.
All right. Let me know what you think. Give some thumbs up and thumbs down based on your experience.
All right. I am learning all about how Copilot can make my Azure Cosmos DB NoSQL queries just that much better, built into the Cosmos DB Data Explorer. Learning about it all today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.